What's up guys, welcome back for another Yu-Gi-Oh! Pro Tool video. New banlist, Salamon Grades have been hit on our upcoming TCG banlist being, you know, Salamon Grade Gazelle is going to one, same for Circle also going to one, and have been testing the deck for the past three hours max, and well, the deck is much weaker, of course, for the most obvious reasons, but the deck definitely needs work, right? I'm still searching, you know, the ratios, the hand traps, back row. It feels that you kind of have to run more level 3 oriented cards, like the Crusadia one. I guess that's fine. I want to try out like Wielder, Psychic Wheel, I believe the name is. So more level 3s, the Backup Secretary, I believe the name is, to facilitate Mirage Stelio. Mirage Stelio, basically an easy search target or an easy target to kind of search out your Salamon Grade Gazelle next to Cyanide Mining, but mining is just that Ash Blossom bait, right? Especially because you discard one card and your opponent will always have that Ash Blossom there. So facilitating the potential Mirage Stelio might be one of those options to go into the new format, but again, don't take this build for granted. The deck definitely needs work, like always. This is just like the first couple of hours of playtesting after our new TCG balance has been revealed. So again, feel free to leave feedback about the list you saw. I think going first, yeah, one of the things here is Manhunt? You know which one I mean, like the quote-unquote Snatchula-like card. It's a decent card, but going second it might be a bit iffy. Again, based myself for this one on the OCG list, or at least on an OCG list, I'm also main-decking Triple Solemn Judgment, so it's something that's debatable of main-decking the Triple Solemn Judgment here in the main deck. Feels a bit iffy, right? Paying half of your life points, then again going first and establishing your weak board, I guess, but yeah, that's you know, the difference between this and the OCG now is that the OCG does have Triple Circle, while we don't have that, so the consistency is definitely a big issue here for Salamon Grades. It feels iffy. So anyway, playtesting against Orcus as well. Yeah, Orcus is still very strong going into the new format. It's a very, it might be a little bit can I call it an Underdark deck? Not really, right, but it's still a very strong deck. Crusadia, Guard Dragons, Thunder Dragons, yeah, Lambda is actually a nice pick. I'm going to steal that one. The Lambda. You know, you can main Gamma, etc. Instead of going for, what's it called? Beat Cup? Main Lambda. Basically the same purpose, right? That generic link to that points down left and down right. But the thing is that lets you run Gamma in your main deck because of Lambda. You know the effect. So definitely very interesting one. But yeah, as people have mentioned on my previous video as well, is that, okay, Crusadia Thunder and Crusadia Danger, etc. is definitely a very strong deck, a superb strong deck, but it has some weaknesses. Again, Konami decided to give us back Super Poly at 3, and as you know, Super Poly is fantastic against that particular Danger Crusadia Dark deck. So, definitely side decking Triple Super Poly, main decking might be, depending on, you know, the formats. Super Poly is, of course, much better compared to, or depends on which deck. Or which decks are going to be good post, or at least in the new format. Hand traps again, superb. Well, you have to main deck multiple hand traps. Ghost Ogre seems to be staple again, no? Because of the Crusadia, Guard Dragons, etc. So anyway, go for Mirage Stelio. Mirage Stelio will eventually search out Salamon Grade Gazelle, and of course, Stelio will bounce back the Colossus. So now I was like, okay, I should be in a decent position, but I think this was the duel where, yeah, I think I called back the Ash Blossom. Was it this one instead of the Gazelle? I was like, okay, making sure that, well, the opponent can't search or something like that, or special summon something from the deck, but ripping the Leviathan. That card is still at 3 for whatever reason, right? With the ban list, I was like, oh, okay, Leviathan at 3, it's fine, but man, that card is still so strong. You can definitely search it off of the, what is it called? You know which one I mean? Awakening? Melody. Yeah, Melody, that's the name. But even then, Melody isn't really being played. Or, well, it's an option, I guess. Anyway, so yeah, going for the Salamon Grade, Heatleo being the link 3, and what can I do, right? Yeah, it was indeed this duel, not getting back the Gazelle. But I don't think it would have mattered that much, right? It's fine though, these are just some fun duels, just trying out here the new format. So going first against Orcus again, my hand is quite decent-ish. Well, it's okay, I guess. It's not compared to like the before the ban list, when opening Gazelle was very easy and set up your multiple back rows, multiple hand traps, and set up basically shut down your opponent or prevent your opponent from playing Yu-Gi-Oh! Connector is still such a badass card. Definitely go, I think I'm forced to Ash Blossom here. There is still the Phantasmate for the potential extra draws. And this is a problem, right? And that the Nightmare Phoenix forcing out my back row being called by the grave. And that's something I needed, especially here for the one of the Orcus cards, right? Yeah, sadly, nope. That's why Phoenix is in there, to force out the back row and call by the grave. It definitely didn't help me here in this situation. So he's able to further establish his board, going for Dingrisu as well. Not really sure if he can go for game. I don't think so. Yeah, because of the failings indeed. My hand. So the options, I do have Foxy. I think I have a Spinny in my graveyard again for the potential bounce with Mirage Stelio. Use Foxy's effect. Bit iffy though. Probably should not have used it, you know, discard something to use Foxy's Mystical Space Typhoon effect. Again, one of those important key plays against the Orcus, you know, getting rid of their field spell. So again, going for, yeah, the Selnogrid, you know, yeah. The standard plays, I guess. Eventually going to end with Dweller indeed, and I was like, okay, I should be in a decent position, especially with Roar and Rage Set. How can I lose this one, right? But Orcus feels like a very again, it's like a deck that you think you're at least you're up in the duel, but then they're great effects and you eventually lose a duel as well. So, whatever, right? To each their own. So I probably should have kept the Roar here. Again, it's rewatching the replays again lets me like judge my own misplays, I guess, or small mistakes. But again, it's fine. So going for Leo again. All right, the Dweller. He forgot the Dweller, and that's the point where I can kind of steal this duel, I guess. So going for Mirage Stelio again. Heat Leo still on the field, and yeah, indeed. Now I can just eventually go for game. So again, Crusadia, Gardragon, Shenanigans going second again. Opening the Ghost Ogre. Ghost Ogre is fine. Prevents the LP from triggering or going off. So that's good. The double call by the grave is a little bit less great, I guess. But yeah, opening the one-off Gazelle is fine though. So there is the Ghost Ogre and the one-off Colossus. Of course, you're drawing the circle then, but it's fine. Again, having Gazelle and eventually Mirage Stelio will bounce back the Colossus, making Circle Light, and Circle will just get some extra searches. And yeah, I think I should be able to lock it up here, especially because of the double Call by the Grave. Call by the Grave, okay, not really doing much now, but well, depending on if he top decks like a Danger or Avian or whatever. So yeah, dealing or this attack with both monsters to attack for some nice damage, I guess, and setting both Call by the Grave and that small Collapse Serpent definitely was a very nice top deck, refueling his hand by banishing the Avian. But yeah, the double Call by the Grave actually coming in clutch here, banishing the Danger Snake and the Thunder Dragon. Yeah, indeed. And this should be game over. Yeah, Wyber Burstar in defense doesn't really matter too much. Just search something else and eventually pump everything onto the field, and eventually I'll just attack for a game, right? That's how it goes. Last example, going second again against Orcus. Look at my hand. No hand. Well, Phantasma is definitely a hand trap. That's good. Hopefully get an extra draw, and I draw Ash Blossom. So I was like, okay, this should be my duel, especially because of the extra minuses here for the... Well, minuses. Well, the extra... Not pluses. Oh, yeah, whatever. Minuses for the opponent. But the Call by the Grave saves his... well, saves his duel, I guess. Prevents the Ash Blossom from going through, and yeah, now he's able to go for the Longrus, indeed. Not really sure if that's it. Well, going into the new format, I guess it's fine, a good Link 3, but there might be better options. And my hand is good, normal summoning the Lady Debugger to search, was it Spinny or Foxy? Foxy, indeed, I think so. Especially because of the... Yes, Silent Mining indeed, and of course getting up the Foxy, or setting up Foxy in the graveyard to use the Mystical Space Typhoon to prevent my opponent from using the Orcus monsters during my turn, so I can go through with my plays. Was thinking about my possible plays here, but I think eventually make an okay play by going for, you know, Sunlight Wolf, eventually get something back right, get Rage back, also setting the Roar eventually, and Mirage Stelio bouncing back the Dingrisso indeed. So yeah, the level 3 Crusadia popping his Link 2. And okay, his field is cleared, and here I was like, okay, how can I lose this one? Again, having Heatleo on the field with a potential 3 pops with Rage and the Roar set as well. But here I underestimated the Longrisu, overlooking the effect that it cannot be destroyed by card effects. So yeah, again, that kind of forces out, or the effect forces out the... Roar indeed, so negating the effect of the Longrisu, but... it's not going to matter, right? It can't be destroyed by card effects and Rage as well. I kind of let myself get into here in this duel. It's a bit unfortunate, right? But it's fine, though. Okay, Call by the Grave is cool. And this is eventually his duel. So it's all fine. It's good. Just playtesting with this, you know, the new format. Again, like always, feel free to leave suggestions. Super Poly seems to be a staple in the side deck. Still thinking about Solemn Judgment in the main deck. Maybe more copies of Solemn Great Rage and Roar. More traps. Maybe less Crackdown Manhunt in the main deck. Maybe more hand traps. Effect Failure maybe. But those are definitely all options. Okay, guys, that's it. Thanks for watching. Feel free to leave a comment or a like if you enjoyed the video. Lead him signing out. Peace.